In this video, we're going to show how the derivative of the xn, x to the power of n, is equal to actually the n multiplied by x raised to the n minus 1 power, right? So basically, we're going to show how the power rule indeed holds, and we're going to use implicit differentiation along with the power rule to actually show that indeed this is true, okay? So keep in mind that the y prime is equal to the derivative of x to the nth power divided by the dx, right? Because y prime is the derivative, basically. It's this n multiplied to the x raised to the n minus first power. So now the conditions hold that n, we're going to assume that n is equal to a over b with a and b non-zero integers, okay? They must be integers because we're going to use the power rule while we use the implicit differentiation, okay? So and also, we're gonna assume that x to the power of a over b is differentiable. Okay. So, since y prime is equal to the derivative of x to the nth power, then y itself must be x raised to the nth power. Right. So that means we can start as y is equal to x raised to the a over b power. Okay, so notice that if we raise y to the power of b, we have to raise the x to the power of b. And this would, the power of a power is such that these powers will multiply, so the b's will cancel out. So as a result, y to the power of b becomes x to the power of a. Okay, so now we're ready to differentiate, okay, to solve for the y prime. So we're going to use the power rule. We're going to say b y b minus 1 multiplied by the y prime is equal to ax to the power of n a minus 1. So that means that to solve for y prime, we're going to have ax to the power of a minus 1 divided by by to the power of b minus 1. Okay, and notice that we have constants a and b, and we said that a over b was n, right? So that means we will have n multiplied by the x a minus 1 divided by b, oops, sorry, y to the power of b minus 1. And then using the properties of exponents, we're going to see that x a will divide x, right? Because a minus 1 means that the base is such that in the denominator you will have x divided by y to the bth power divided by the y. And then we're going to have n multiplied by x to the eighth power divided by x multiplied by the y divided by the y to the bth power. And that leads to n times xa divided by yb multiplied by the y over x. And that leads to, notice that y to the bth power was equal to the x to the eighth power. So that means that we would have n multiplied by xa divided by xa, right? Because we can just substitute. And then y over x. And what is y? It's x to the a over b power, right? Well, let's see. Y over x, y over x. Yeah, so a, so so x to the a over b power divided by x. And that is going to give us n okay, just want to make it clearer a little bit. So that's going to give us a n times 1 times x n divided by x, right? And that simply leads to n x n minus 1, right? X to the power of n minus 1. And this shows that indeed the power rule holds. Okay, so we just used implicit differentiation along with the power rule, where we just assumed these conditions to hold. We showed that indeed the power rule holds. So thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in my next video.